ho preso tante idee e all'interno di tutte queste idee l'idea più grande che porto via con me è: il tempo è solo ora, il tempo è solo la mia capacità di restare in questo istante con tutto me stesso, con la volontà di entrare in relazione con tutte le mie risorse e capacità, con ciò che mi circonda. Una ospite straordinaria.
I want to propose to all of you a different face of an Arab woman, not condemned to silence, not owned by a man or another. I mean, husband, father, brother or son, and worse, male public power. By help of excellence, I became free and inviolable, contrarily to the massive part of Arab and Islamic women. I was born in Rabat in a very conservative family, which ancestors 5 centuries ago were living in Andalusia. I was the first in my maternal and paternal families to be born in a modern medical system, and this is a destiny. After that, I was to be sent in the most revolutionary, modern, and the best schools for girls in the heart of French colonial system. It's why I am today in front of you and so happy to be there. Taboos were so strong that I was unable before the psychoanalysis to speak in the Arabic dialect of my family and ancestors, as I was too well colonized by French system. I spoke just French for all my childhood and teenage. I was the first in front and before French girls trained to be the unique Arab in the classroom. Excellence saved me. My life is built on this possibility to be excellent or not to be. I had to face a monstrous event for a Muslim young girl. I became orphan in a triumphant patriarchal system based on the power of male dictators. An orphan in such societies is just a nothing. But overall, a girl in those conditions is less than nothing. She is a plague. I became a plague, persecuted by my own large family, aunts, neighbors, men in the streets, people having a power or another. In short period, I reacted like I had to do. I choose behavior of excellence. I have to say something, and this is an homage to my father. When I was not the first in the classroom, he was used not to speak with me for some days during the summer. And this was a conditioning system for excellence. These people despising me were Moroccan men, very annoyed by such a monster. I was just beside what was waited from an Arabic girl. Excellence is a road, it's a brand. Is something given like a holy mark by God, a concentration, a production of highest quality, a search for well-being. It's an effort. It's a huge amount of labor. Sometimes it means a foolish courage, like this of sending a letter to the King of Morocco. First time it was done by a woman in the whole Arabic Islamic world. A suggestion to the young generation: please, please, be excellent. Believe in your own power to be yourself, to create, to go all together, hand in hand. My contribution can give a sense, next excellence for the world is to build a beautiful life in peace, without hatred or racism, putting in common resources, protecting natures, and developing culture as the most important richness of mankind. One day, all men and women are going to be happy.
L'eccellenza è educazione. L'eccellenza è una linea di continuità e per poterla perseguire bisogna educarsi. Avere persone che si prendano cura di noi, dei veri e propri maestri. Exducere infatti vuol dire tirar fuori cosa? Non le peggiori emozioni, non i peggiori difetti che accompagnano ognuno di noi. Educarsi vuol dire scoprire che si è anche capaci, come specie e come individui, di provare amore, distacco, determinazione. Essere quindi in grado di fare la differenza attraverso un processo meraviglioso che è decidere. Quindi Ritel Kayat ci ha regalato questa straordinaria idea. Ancora oggi i maestri sono non necessari, molto di più indispensabili. In una società che non vuole maestri, in una società che... voi col napoletano come andate? Male, eh? Però io lo dico lo stesso. A casa mia si dice nascem barat, sei nato sapiente. Una società che afferma che ognuno di noi sa già tutto fin dalla nascita, non è la verità, dobbiamo istruirci, dobbiamo educarci, dobbiamo accettare, altro segreto fondamentale, l'allenamento. Lasciarsi educare è diventare consapevoli della necessità che ogni uomo ha di essere allenato da un altro uomo. Lo riconosciamo con facilità nello sport. Ad Atene lo sport era una filosofia di vita. Dobbiamo non dimenticarlo, dobbiamo ricordarlo a noi stessi.